the efficacy of masks outside. Have been any peer-reviewed studies to suggest that wearing masks outside is an effective tool in this battle?
Okay, so you know, this is sort of a unfortunately a politicized
right.
issue
I'm not
also.
Trying to ask it from a political perspective. I'm simply trying to understand, because this is about us filtering that the science. Is there any peer-reviewed study that suggests that?
Let me answer it this way. If you look at the WHO website, and regardless of political views about leadership or anything like that, I'm not going to get into that, but if you look at the science, the WHO has done that, and the WHO says as of June 7th, and to my knowledge, it's not been changed, and I looked a couple days ago, there, quote, there is no sound science that the general population should always wear masks. However, in certain circumstances, and this meshes exactly with what President Trump's policy is, wear masks when you cannot socially distance, particularly if you're near high-risk groups and when there's high transmission in the community. Okay, but in terms of a general all-population, everywhere wearing a mask, no, there is no sound science. If you, and you don't even have to be a scientist. If you're in the middle of a desert all alone, is it sensible to wear a mask? If you're inside your own car all alone, I mean, I don't know what you're doing. If you're jogging in a park all alone with no one around you, should be wearing a mask? I mean, you know, I think the American people understand this. It's not even something that needs to be said, yet you're some sort of a heretic for pointing out the obvious. Sometimes 1 + 1 = 2.
So on data, and specifically how it pertains to, you know, life and death, I've heard yourself, Kayleigh McEnany, the president talk about how important excess mortality is, the excess mortality rate, when you're sort of analyzing what our response has been. I don't disagree with that. But why wouldn't total deaths also be at the forefront of that analysis?
Okay, so by the way, I'll just introduce the topic by saying that epidemiologists, and I actually communicate with some of the world's best epidemiologists, but epidemiologists, in my assessment or opinion, use and understand excess mortality and excess mortality rates if you're going to compare countries. Because it's not a topic that is calculated on these sort of low-level websites that people seem to flock to, because they like to, it's easier to say deaths and deaths per capita or deaths per million. But when you take a country that has you have to include everything that's happening with the deaths from the pandemic. And one of the problems if you're going to compare countries, is there's a lot of differences in how a death is categorized. We know even in our own country, some people are categorized as COVID-19 deaths, but they were never tested. Some people are tested as COVID-19, they're tested positive, but they may have died from something else. There are problems with undercounting COVID-19 deaths. There are problems with overcounting COVID-19 deaths. There are differences between countries. Some countries have different tests. Some countries test with less sensitive techniques. Some countries don't test many people. Some countries have people die and they don't know what the cause is and they don't include them. So to get rid of all those inconsistencies, all those uncertainties, there's something called excess deaths, excess mortality rate specifically. Excess mortality rate considers during your pandemic period, and of course the pandemic period of one country may be slightly shifted from the pandemic period of the other. In a pandemic period for the United States, for instance, or for any country, you take the number of deaths beyond or over what would have occurred without the pandemic. Okay, this is not some kind of a strange statistic. It is a standard epidemiological statistic. And yes, I'm not an epidemiologist for all those who are asking, but I know how to read. And, you know, epidemiology statistic of excess mortality rate is a very simple statistic. It's not some kind of fantastically complicated math thing. You take the number of deaths that occurred beyond what was expected without the pandemic, and every country has its own level of healthcare, level of health, level of a medical system for deaths. So we use our baseline of deaths, meaning deaths without the pandemic, the deaths over that. So you subtract that, you take a percent extra deaths, excess deaths, so that it accounts for all the deaths. And that includes, by the way, the deaths that you happen to cause by stopping medical care, because that counts. What you did during the pandemic counts. And then you take, I'm sorry to go on, but
it's very important.
Yeah. But, we want to know.
Okay. So the excess mortality rate for the US happens to be a certain number. And as of the latest available data, it's roughly 20%. It's 19.9% from my calculation. And when you look at Europe as a group, and the data is available for a set of 24 countries, And you take their standard expected deaths during their pandemic period, and you look at the period of deaths that were beyond that during the pandemic, and you calculate their excess mortality rate, the same thing. Their percent is 28%, as of the latest available data that I looked at, their percent is 28% worse than the United States. Therefore, in a rational, factual comparison of, if you want to use deaths to compare how countries did, the US did better than Europe, period.